The Manhattan Project was a massive U.S. wartime program to develop an atomic weapon. In 1942, General Leslie R. Groves, who led the effort, hired the DuPont Corporation to build plutonium production plants. To find laborers, DuPont looked to the South, states like Mississippi, Alabama, and Georgia, offering good wages and a ticket to the project site in Hanford, Washington. Jackie Peterson describes the recruitment process.
Initially, the Manhattan Project recruitment strategy was, I feel, slightly self-confident. People thought, well, we're just going to put it out there, you know, the whole idea of if you build it, they will come. And so they got an initial wave of folks primarily through in-person recruitment. So there were teams of folks who would literally day by day show up in different places in the country. People would turn up at their office. They'd be given a little ticket with their name and number. And again, if they were fortunate to have the funds, the individuals would be given some money to pay for their train or bus fare, and then they would show up in Hanford and turn in the ticket they were given at the recruitment office. And so once people started to get wind of that and they kind of figured out where to go, a lot of people just bypassed that sort of formal showing up at the office process and just ended up showing up in Hanford. They would drive, they would take buses, and they would say, hey, I heard this radio ad, or I saw this in the newspaper. I hear there are jobs here. Can I work? And I think at the time, people were so drawn by the financial opportunity that it didn't really matter, that they didn't know what they were going to be working on.
Phil Gardner traveled over 100,000 miles recruiting employees of all backgrounds for Hanford. He describes the Manhattan Project's desperate need for workers.
We're paying $1 an hour. It was a big shortage. We were hiring a lot of these people. We were taking their word for it that they were mechanics. Well, I recall one day in Kansas City, Colonel Mathias, who was the commanding officer on the job, and Gil Church, who was the project manager, were out visiting me and calling on the War Manpower Commission to impress on them the importance of this job. While we got back to the hotel, the colonel asked me if it were true that our recruiters would hire a man as a carpenter if he could identify a hammer. And we said, well, no, we were not quite that tough. If he could convince us that his father would have known what the tool was, or we'd perhaps take him.